Professor Dušan Mitić, who is the Dean and Director of the Belgrade Sports Faculty in Serbia. Serbia is a beautiful country in Eastern Europe. Dušan is an expert within the area of sport for all, and his outputs here link coherently into the health and well-being agenda. He is a governmental advisor, he is also a member of the country's National Olympic Committee, and he is a key strategic lead in the TAFISA European Steering Committee. Dušan's title or presentation today is on supporting active and healthy lifestyles. This is clearly a global initiative and concern, and I really look forward to listening to this. So Dušan, over to you.
Ladies and gentlemen, dear colleague, it is really my big pleasure to be here today with you and talking about my favorite topics, how we can change something. I came from one small country in the middle of Europe. Obviously, 20 years ago it was more bigger, but we have bad luck and we destroyed a lot of that. But there lives still proud people, and we like to be independent and give our best to make it on the best way. We are only 7 million and a half, it's a little smaller than Ningbo, but we try to make our best, especially in field of sport. And when I'm talking about me, I grew like usually children in that way. We have a lot of different activity outside, and we was lucky to grow with that activity. When I said lucky, you will see today children don't have so many activity because the life is changing and we growing very fast. And on my professional way, I try to growing possibility for everyone to be more physical active, and very often we talking about that, how we can change the sport and modificate some activity to be close to the regular people, and most of them be more physical active. I also part of Sport for All movement in my country, and we provide a lot of summer, winter festival and a lot of different activity quite to be together. Like a humankind, we think that we growing very fast, but it's all the time the question, where are we going? Because when you're looking at the data and what's happened around us, we recognize a lot of problems. We try to resolve a lot of situation. We have too many administration. We make our business only with the finger, using the big, strong machine, and try to resolve situation where the life put in front of us. It's also entertainment can be on that way. It was old picture from 10 years ago. Nowadays it's changing. Nowadays we use the mobile phone and all the time we must be in connection. When I came 2 weeks ago in China, it was the first picture. Like in all around the world, a lot of many smartphone and people all the time looking in the smartphone. The people don't look around. We lose contact face to face. We use only Facebook to contact with other people and Instagram. And I think it can be a great problem for all of us, because according to that, we lose regular physical activity and became really inactive. It's changed a lot. For 100 years, on the same corner, you can recognize it will be different. But now it's the family in the network. The question is, the family really enjoying that, or maybe it's better on that way? I suggest to be on that way, to be more physical active, to be to give a good example for the children and be with them, really be with them, because I think the children have the biggest problem. 20 years ago, when the children play football, it means take the ball and go outside. Nowadays, when they said I play football, it means I take new software for the plane. 20 years ago, it's a problem for the parents to follow the children to going home to take meal. Nowadays, the problem for the parents to give the reason to children to go outside. And when you look at the data, 81%, 28% of elderly people take some advice, but 81% of children don't have enough physical activity, and it will be a problem in the future for all of us. And when you look at the data according to the girls and boys, it's just a little small difference. And also outdoor activity is really decreased from 70% to 21% go outside. Our children nowadays is not make body weight high. 1 per 20 was 20 years ago, 1 per 10 today is not possible to make. And also when you're talking about the children and what's happened in the last 50 years. In 70 years ago, the children had freedom to go around 10 kilometers around the home. In the 1965 it was 3 kilometers. In 1919 it was 300 meters. But nowadays it's 30 meters. Children lose the freedom to have to play outside, to be alone and investigate. All the time somebody other must be with them. And the physical ability also decreases. They need 19 seconds more for the same distance like before. The heart problem is going on. And especially for the young children is the problem. When they finish the holiday, they lose 80% of ability what we take during the physical education lesson during the school year. Because in the free time with parents, they don't have enough physical activity. And it is really shock data for me. I take it 2 weeks ago in Tokyo when one man from United Kingdom talking that practically 75% of children have less physical activity than people which stay in person. It is the not personal decision when you're talking about the children. It is responsibility of parents, responsibility of local authority, and maybe the government. All of us have the similar problem. They want to go to fitness club and use the usually elevator. And it is the champion of new lifestyle. He tried to cheat themselves. And very often we have that situation. When we are talking with other people, is that physical activity is necessary? The big part of them, 90% they said, yes, we have to do physical activity. But if you offer to them elevator instead, they use the elevator. It is more easier because we are lazy to do. It's nice data that in China, a lady recognized the problem and a lady with knowledge take care about the body weight and body mass index going better. It means knowledge can help, but it's the problem for other society. We lose a reason to be more physical active on the workplace because decrease the part of muscle activity during that. And our growing very fast, we use a different sort of energy, but we lose physical activity. That is a really big problem for our body. Our body try to resolve situation which we look in front of them. We don't have situation for inactivity. Our body don't found situation for that. We must advise the people to be more physical active, to increase the metabolism and have the better posture situation and resolve that changing. It's something changed from that picture. You can recognize. It's really changed. But that change became the problem. The global level of physical inactivity is the problem for all the association all around the world. We have the really similar problem. And A few years ago, one big responsible company, and according with the Association of Professors of Physical Education, tried to put the data in front of people to help them to be more physical active, because they recognized that the children don't have a chance to live like the parents, because they grow up on the way which is not healthy and not good good for continued on that way. And also, it is data from that investigation that is a problem all around the world. And also, in China, they give the data and they recognize the problem, and the prognosis is similar, because the China changing very much, very fast. Maybe too fast, and that is not easy to recognize what really happened. 30 years ago, the bicycle was main for transport in China. Nowadays, it will be a lot of cars. And that changing is happened too fast, and that can really be a problem. The World Health Organization recognized physical inactivity like the separate problem, because they produce the problem. The problem is more bigger in inactive population than in active population. And according to that, they recognize that a lot of problem is stay behind the physical inactivity. And according to our research, maybe the physical inactivity is responsible for 2/3 of problem in the non-chronic diseases, because behind the obesity you have physical activity, behind the problem of sugar you have also have physical inactivity. And when you look at the data, how the obesity is growing, for me it was interesting to making some cross, and for me the main reason is, and more responsible, is the mass media. Because when you're looking what's happened in the UK and Australia and USA, it is the country where the really growing the professional sport. But media motivate people to be, to look the sport, not to provide the sport. It is the one of the big problem we have with media, because media must survive. They're looking for market, they're looking for money, and the sport, especially looking at the professional sport, is good market, but that is not good for the regular people, because the problem is growing too fast. And especially the same problem with the overweight children. I'm sure that the professor will be talking about that more than me, and I don't lose the time in that way too much. We have many medical reports. And the for me is really important that is not the report which make the professor of physical education or professor of sport, because when the medical give to us data, it means that they are not quite interested to growing up our story, because it is out of them main interest. I'm sure that medical doctor is not so much interesting to grow in the physical activity, to decrease the investment in the health. But if we invest in physical activity, we can resolve a lot of problem. And when you're looking at the data, new data from Japan said we must give more money than before to resolve the problem of physical inactivity. And they give that 30% of total budget going to medical health system, because the medical problem is growing too fast, and that be a big pressure for the medical care system. And you can see it is the small group which can be more quality, have quality of life. World Health Organization recommend for that vulnerable group, you must make something like a state, like a society. And if you're looking that, practically all of us is somewhere. Or we in adolescent phase, or maybe we under the stress, or have some non-communicable diseases, and so on. What can we do again that? In last 50 years, we have a lot of recommendation. From simple recommendation, make minimum 10,000 steps per day, or in Japan they said minimum 40,000. Our World Health Organization every 10 years give new advice for the all. Minimum five times per week. It was 20 years ago, and after that they said every day half hour of physical activity. And when you look in the list, you will see it is not all done the 30 minutes. It can be 50 minutes, it can be 45 minutes, but all the time we're talking about the burning the calories during the activity. It is minimum. If you want to protect your heart, to don't have the heart stroke. Or, new said, more is better. If you, you want to protect yourself and your body, you must invest in burning more calories themselves. Or if you more invest, you can more inspect more benefit for your body. And nowadays, the recommendation is divided in few sectors. For the younger, it must be minimum 75 to 150 minutes, or for the children from 60 minutes free time per week, and especially advising for the young population. Less than 5 years, it means with parents at the beginning of system support, it must be more physical activity and less looking to the screen. We have the doctor prohibition, children under 1 year, it is not necessary to look to any screen. After that, maybe 1 hour per day. And we have a new tactic from World Health Organization. They give a lot of recommendation what can we do, like society, and we must change many times because the situation is changing from day to day. You have new generation rise up on the new way, and according to that we must looking for the new solution. We have global action plan, and we can support that, but all the time we must looking for the new possibility. For the people which is similar to me, more than 60 years, minimum 60 minutes per day, cumulative physical activity. And we are looking for data, we have a theory. If you have more years, you must invest more in physical activity to support your health and well-being. And also, it is a data which talking about the same. If we increase physical activity, it will be decrease the problem with heart attack. Around 2,000 to 3,000 calories, if you burn that during the week, it's the best police of injury for your health. And also, 3 or 4 times per week, it can be pretty nice, and we have a lot of investigation in that way. And the problem can be resolved. When you're looking at the data from Finland, in last 40 years, they working permanent to resolve that problem and decrease the problem with heart attack. But it means a long period, we have, they use the same strategy. They change a lot of government, but they don't change the strategy. If you can work in that, on that way, it's possible to change something. And just a few examples from Serbia. Old lady, which practice minimum 2 times per month, have activity, go to some mountain, have a really nice situation. The body function on a good way, they have flexibility, they have high level of cardiopulmonary potential, they have nice motor function, and generally they have a lot of social contact. They have full quality of life. Well, one young investigation wants to compare what's happened if the people continue to play volleyball all his life. We have a group of people which have over 60, which play volleyball 2 or 3 times per week, and people which mountaineering. and compare with the group of officers which work for military service. The officer was younger, 20 years, but we have the same situation with motor ability and really good data that physical activity can continue the quality of life, not only the quantity of year. And maybe it will be interesting for professor about we're talking about the physiology. In exercise physiology, we test in two groups. In one group, we have regular physical activity all time in aerobic zone, and the other group was 30% in anaerobic threshold. Both groups have the better result, but in the end, we don't have a difference between group. It means that it's not necessary to provocate the problem. Because all the time when you go on submaximal and maximal zone, you can provocate the problem. We can increase the physical ability without making the problem. We're talking about the regular people. A lot of society tried to resolve the problem. Train movement start in Norwegian, and for the beginning they try to motivate the people to be more physical active and give a lot of poster, organize the presentation, give to them feeling that they can do something, they can make something, motivate the sport organization to change the sport according to the possibility of the people. Not only all the time talking about the competitive sport and 1% of talent people. And you can see that a lot of different idea what is happening when you want to motivate people. Sometimes it's motivation for people. If you pass this month more than 100 kilometers through the mountain, we give you a small badge. If you for 6 months, if you pass more than 200 kilometers, we give you silver badge. If you for 1 year pass more than 500 kilometers, you have the gold badge, or you have the diamond badge. But with that badge, I said, I make something for me. Maybe you want to be with me to make something together. On that way, we support each other to be more physical active and looking for the possibility how we can choose the good bicycle, how we can taste it ourselves, what can we do for that small brochure, and giving the points for the people. If you are more active, it can be more useful for you on a different way. It is a lot of model we collecting during the last 15 years, and all the time is the message. It's a place for the elder people, and also lady can do that, and maybe if you make it like a family, it will be really nice for all of us. And it is the all data from Canada, maybe Sean recognize that. In one period they invest a lot in physical activity and give the data. If you invest $1 in promotion of physical activity, you can save the $10 of healthcare system. Because in one period, they increased the number of people who became physical active and recognized that in healthcare system, they save the money. And if you have one active person, it means you save 400 euro per year. And a different model in Slovakia, they support the people to every month have the other sort of activity, because it depends from the, you can make it in the nature. Normally, if you take care about you, we give you the small book. You can measure every month what are you doing and how you're going in your better situation. And also, in our country, we make a lot of, we have in one period really strong support of the state, and have the real movement with a lot of sport organization must do something for the people increasing physical activity. And like faculty, we testing the, a lot of models, how we increase the number of people who will be physical active. And when I talk, we must change. If we have from year to year story about the challenge day. If you make it all the time on the same way, after 3 or 4 years, it became boring. And people give up from that. All the time we must make something new for them, to provocate them to be more physical active, and especially we have a lot of experience with the students' game and changing the model of that. We start to growing the number of people which skiing. After few years, we recognize that exists the problem. In family with small children, that is not possible to resolve the problem. The children is growing. And you must change the shoes, you must change something. And it start like it's changing equipment, and after that it's growing and became international fair of winter sport activity, and it's good money from the market, from the Sport for All like organization, and it's a good support for the people who like the winter sport activity, because that weekend we came to be together, to looking our friends, because we became the same society, we like the same activity, and we support each other in different sort of activity and to be more physical active. Public and private cooperation, yes, it's possible, but according to our experience, it's really important to have support of from the different part of the government, from the different sector. Also, sport club, family, education system maybe can prevent and resolve the problem with the overweight, but together, not any organization alone. And all around the world they have a different activity to support each other, to many marathon, half marathon race, exercise together. In Denmark they make a lot of that to be more friendly to people, to provocate children to be more physical active. They said Denmark is boring and we must make some bump on the field ground to provocate the children to be more physical active and offer to them activity to exercise, to investigate, looking for the something new. They support really strong people to use the bicycle. They make a special road for that, and a lot of people really use that. And also, all the time you must make some promotion to support the people to be more physical active in a different sort of activity, especially for disability people, can be really important to feel that they can. If you can, you will do, and that it's a really good message for all of us. In Israel, they making some amazing walking festival, international public transport, and a lot of supporting people to be more physical active. It's all around the world, it's the same sport, the problem. And all the time, it is the personal choice. If I know, I can do, but how I be physical active and what I eat, it's the all the time personal decision about that. It's the style of life. That lady never give up on physical activity because it is something good for her. Or you can find a solution for your problem with children and found some hobby activity. Or it's a nice example from China. I was lucky to be a few times in China, and it is a lot of picture from that in China. It's quite, you can find a lot of nice picture and nice solution. And also China have, like the other world, soy plant. But I made that picture from my window. But on that picture, you don't found the child. Anyone. Last 12 days, I'm looking every morning, every afternoon. I never saw anyone on that really nice. It's perfect. But without child, it's nothing. That is not enough to make something what can be used. We must support each other to be more physical active and looking the way how to provocate that, how we really increase the physical activity. I'm afraid that we don't have time to pass for all the time. I want to go only to talking about one big area. Different model, we tasting a lot of that, but lifestyle and what can we do, like a tourist, what can we do for ourselves? It is one of the most important and really big market. Sport tourism is a really big market, and that can be very useful for some society to provide a lot of activity. And also, when you make a choice to be somewhere on your holiday, that holiday can also be active and can have a lot of activity which provocate to be more physical active with your child, with your family, to exercise together, because when we're talking about the active lifestyle, when we learn, when we move, we have more chance to survive and to have more activity to be together and support each other. And also, the last part is only just a few understanding. We can use electronic device and social network to find the target group. According to that, we can resolve the problem. We must use and growing up, what can we do with the different electronic device and the social network to provocate the people not only to have the information, to be more physical active, because it can be action to make it together, or we can measure how we are physical active, because a lot of electronic devices give to us really nice data how we can, and support us to be more physical active, and give the challenge to the other, and connect that with all that activity. And my last slide will be only, I put maybe too many, never give up. Because when you give up from physical activity, practically, you give up from life. Thank you.
I'm conscious of the time, so if somebody's got a very brief question, I'm happy to accept that. Yeah, one minute, please. Just one question. So, lady in the front here. Thank you.
Dr. Mitić, I'm Claudia Wang from Ningbo University. Really, really enjoy your presentation. And I have one question, maybe big, but just want to get some brief answers from you. And well, during your presentation, you mentioned the physical active level has dropped a lot in China. So I'm just wondering, what are your top three suggestions for Chinese people to improve children's physical active level?
For the beginning, children, parents must take information. Local authority can support them to be more physical active. It's the really problem in the family, and the knowledge is the biggest possibility for resolving that problem.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much. Thanks, Dušan. It's a pleasure to introduce our final speaker of the morning session. Dr. Sean Robbins is an associate professor at McGill University in Canada. And